So now we have a complete boot upper because I sewed along here to the tongue, and then I turned it around, brought it around, and I sewed along here to the tongue. So you can see we have a complete boot upper. The next step really is to take your very, very fine scissors and to just really trim both, like right along, I don't know if you can even see this seam, but this seam on the inside, it leaves a flap on this side. And you need to trim that, like angle cut it out. That needs to be angle cut out. Otherwise, it makes it hard to apply the sole. And then you need to come along the edges here, right along the edges of this, and you need to trim down. You need to trim down the felt, because the felt adds a lot of bulk. And I just come in here with my little scissors and I get my the imposition between the seam there and the leather, and I just trim back the felt a little bit, and that makes the boot fit better onto the sole. So I just trim that back just a little bit. And it's hard to see when the boot's black, obviously. You'll notice that the liner of the tongue is loose here. I didn't sew it down to the boot. So I just trim it back. I let it, and then I just poke it in there and let it rest in there. All right, so then you take your doll, and when you're making the second shoe, you need to make sure that the shoe you're making is the opposite to the other shoe. I have done the work and made two left shoes before. So I make sure that I'm doing the correct shoe, and this is a right shoe because this one that I'd finished already is the left, so I've got the right shoe here. So I know that I put an X right here to know that that is the inside of the shoe or the top of the sole. And this side is the part that is going to be covered. So then I take this and I poke this sole into the toe part where it was sewn. And it fits really nicely there just because of this is sewn, it actually hugs it really nicely. And my goal isn't necessarily to get the felt to bend over the and to glue down the felt, but to glue down all the leather. One of the things that I found about the leather is that when you work with vinyl, you have to snip all along and cut out pieces. Leather, especially this thin leather, seems to be more forgiving, and it just sort of wraps itself around. So actually, in this respect, the leather is easier to work with. So I just put a little bit of glue right there. Loving this Aline's glue gun, by the way, that I got from, it's called the Aline's Ultimate Glue Gun. It has a really fine tip. And you can use, it's really precision in terms of being able to shoot out just enough glue. So obviously I'm gluing down. I like working with hot glue because it's fast and I'm not patient. And I know Diane likes to work with wet glue because she doesn't like to be burned. And I just like the hot glue. I think it works fast and I'm not patient. And especially if you're working with vinyl, which I do a lot of vinyl shoes, the hot glue actually kind of heats the vinyl up and allows it to mold itself, kind of helps it mold better to the shoe bottom, I find. So I'm just going all the way around with the hot glue. And now it's really starting to look like a shoe. Hot glue gets everywhere. It's kind of messy, but it's really starting to look like a shoe. All right. So next step is to apply the base. And you got to make sure that you're putting it on correctly and that you're putting the glue on the correct side. And the way that I've come to start doing it is I do this, and then I lay the sole down, and I apply the glue to the sole, to the outer sole. And I do that because it doesn't if you put the glue on the bottom of the shoe right now, the heat of the glue that you're applying to the bottom of the shoe will actually remelt the glue, remelt the glue that you use to apply the sole to the base, and then it, and then your shoe comes apart on you. So I just stick it down there, and I put a lot of glue on. I find hot glue is fairly easy to just peel off once it's cooled. So I put a lot of glue on. And it shifts. It's a little forgiving for a few minutes. You can, for, you know, 30 seconds or so, you can kind of shift it around. I go inside and I push that, so the two soles together. Obviously, if you've got a lot of bulk in between your upper and your inner and your outer sole, you're going to want to put something in the center to compensate for that. If you're using a good thick vinyl, that might be the case. But with this leather, it's really actually thin and it just comes out pretty nice. So my shoe is now nearly done. All I need to do is add the laces and try it on the doll. So, and you know, maybe snip off the odd little trailing thread. Sometimes right here, I sewed a full eighth of an inch and it just looks a little kind of, there's like a little flap. So I just come in with these nice little sharp scissors and just kind of trim them down a bit so that it looks nice. All right, so I'm going to put the laces on and then I'm going to put it on the doll and you'll see the end product. All right, and there they are. A nice pair of witch boots for the Heart for Heart dolls. Have a great day. Bye.